Friends, today we are going to study condition of reciprocity in two-port parameter representation. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to describe condition of reciprocity in two-port parameter representation. So in today's lecture, we are going to study what is the condition of reciprocity in two-port parameter like Z parameter, Y parameter, H parameter or ABCD parameter. So from this, today we are going to see what is the condition of reciprocity for Z parameters. But before starting with the derivation or condition of reciprocity, you have to pause this video here and you should recall the equations which are to be related to Z parameter and which are dependent and independent variables used while writing the equations for Z parameters. Now we'll start the condition of reciprocity in two-port parameter representation for Z parameters. Okay, while studying this, we have to write down the equations related to Z parameters. But before that, we'll see what is the condition of reciprocity. Basically, a network is said to be reciprocal if the ratio of excitation variable and response variable of a two-port network is same, even if we interchange the excitation as well as response of a two-port network. Okay, so first we'll draw the diagram related to that excitation variable as well as response variable, and this is two-port network. Here it is the excitation, voltage V1, current I1, and we have to short circuit the output. This is current I2 and this is minus I2 because the direction is opposite. So conditions in this case are: V1 should be considered as a Vs, current I1 is I1, current V2 is equal to 0 and current I2 is equal to minus I2. Okay, so first we'll write the equation of Z parameters, and the equations are: V1 is equal to Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2, and second equation is V2 is equal to Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. Is it? Now we'll put the values of these four variables in these two equations. Okay. So now V1 is Vs. So Vs is equal to Z11 I1 minus Z12 I2, because value of I2 is minus I2 because of this opposite direction, and value of V2 is 0 because output port is short circuited. So value of V2 is 0. So 0 is equal to Z21 I1 minus Z22 I2. Okay. So from this second equation, we'll get the value of I1 as I1 is equal to Z22 I2 upon Z21. Okay, so we'll call it this as a equation 1, this as a equation 2, this as a equation 3, and this as a equation 4. Okay, now we'll put the value of I1 in equation number 3. Vs is equal to Z11 Z22 into I2 divided by Z21 minus Z12 I2. Is it? Now Vs is equal to Z11 Z22 I2 minus Z12 Z21 into I2, and when this term goes to the left side, that should be multiplied, so it is Z21. Is it? So Z21 Vs is equal to I2 into Z11 Z22 minus Z12 Z21. Is it? So from this we can find out the value of current I2 as Z21 Vs upon Z11 Z22 minus Z12 and Z21. Is it? So this is the value of current I2, and for the circuit to be reciprocal, the condition is I1 by V1 at V2 is equal to 0 should be equal to I2 by V2 at V1 is equal to 0. Okay. So we have to check for this condition. So presently we get the value of I2. So ratio I2 by Vs is Z21 by, this is mod Z. Okay. Mod Z means determinant of that Z matrix. Okay. So determinant of that Z matrix is Z11 Z22 minus Z12 Z21. Is it? So similarly, we'll go for the second condition, and for that we have to draw the diagram. So again, this is two port network. Now we have to short the port 1. This is current I1, this is minus I1, and here we have to give the excitation plus minus voltage V2, current I2, and now here conditions are voltage V1 is 0 because port 1 is short circuited, current I1 is equal to minus I1 because of the direction change, current I2 is equal to I2, and V2 we will consider it as a Vs, that is source voltage. Is it? Now we derive for this. So equation for Z parameters, again we have to write V1 is equal to Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2, V2 is equal to Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. These are the equations related to the Z parameter, equation 1, equation 2. Now we'll put the conditions in this case, in these two equations. So 0 is equal to minus Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2, equation 3, and Vs is equal to minus Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. We'll make this as equation number 4. So from equation number 3, we'll get the value of I2 as Z11 I1 upon Z12. Is it? Now we have to put the value of I2 in equation number 4. Is it? So we'll get the ratio. So Vs is equal to minus Z21 I1 plus Z22, instead of I2 we have to write Z11 I1 upon Z12. Is it? Okay, so next step, Vs is equal to, if we simplify this, this will be minus Z12, Z21, I1 plus Z22, Z11, I1, and this term will go to left hand side. So it is to be multiplied with Vs, is it? So after this, next step, we'll directly write the value of current I1 as I1 is equal to Z12 Vs upon Z11 Z22 minus Z12 Z21, is it? So I1 by Vs is equal to Z12 by mod Z, is it? So this is the ratio of V1, sorry, I1 by Vs. So for the condition of reciprocity, okay, we have to go for this I1 by V1 at V2 equal to 0 should be equal to I2 by V2 at V1 is equal to 0. Okay, so if we compare this with the resultants, we are getting that I1 by Vs should be is equal to I2 by Vs. So this is the condition of reciprocity. So from this, Z12 by mod Z is equal to Z21 by mod Z. Okay. So this mod Z get cancelled. Okay. And we get the condition of reciprocity as Z12 is equal to Z21. Okay. So this is the condition of reciprocity. So like this, we can find out the condition of reciprocity for Y parameter, G parameter, H parameter or ABCD parameter. While preparing this video lecture, I have used circuit theory, analysis and synthesis by A. Chakravarti. Thank you.